Hello students, today we will discuss about chapter number 1, matter and its composition. In last class we have to discuss about matter, their characteristics, particles of matter, their characteristics, etc. Now we discuss about interconversion of matter or interconversion of states of matter. Means every state like solid, liquid, gas change into each other, that is known as a interconversion of states of matter. Means a solid change into gas, a solid change into liquid, liquid again change into solid, gas change into solid, liquid change into gas, gas change into liquid, that is known as interconversion of matter or states of a matter. When solid change into liquid, when a solid change into liquid, that process is known as a melting. That process is known as a melting. Ice change into water by the process of a melting. By the process of a melting. After that, water again change into ice. When we freezes it, it is known as a solidification. Solidification. Okay. Means a solid change into liquid, that is known as melting. Means ice melt and convert into water, water again freezes and change into ice or solid, that is known as a solidification. After that, liquid change into gas. Liquid change into gas means water change into water vapors. Water vapors, that is known as vaporization. That process is known as a vaporization. And when we cool down these water vapor or condense them, that is change again into water, and that process is known as a condensation. That process is known as a condensation. Means water change into water vapor, that is known as vaporization. And water vapor again change into water, means when we cool down the water vapors, that is known as a condensation. Means condense the water vapor, change into water or liquid, that is known as a condensation. Means next one, solid change into gases and gases change into solid. Solid like a naphthalene ball. Naphthalene balls directly change into gas. Directly change into gas means you have to see, we use the naphthalene balls for preservative of our clothes. After some time they disappear. They disappear means can't change into liquid. Solid state can't change into liquid and only convert into gaseous form. This process is known as a sublimation. This process is known as a sublimation. Sublimation means a solid directly change into gaseous state, that is known as a sublimation. After that, gas change into solid. Gas change into solid. You have to know CO2 is a gas. Carbon dioxide is a gas. It directly change into solid. Means in the form of dry ice. Dry ice. That process is known as a deposition. Deposition. That process is known as a deposition. Means when we compress carbon dioxide gas, that will change into ice form. Ice form or solid form. That is known as a deposition process, and that's why carbon dioxide is also known as a dry ice. And we have to take example of acetone, etc. When we heat up the acetone, it's change into vapors. It's change into vapors. But we take a funnel on it and close the mouth of funnel. Here is burner. When we heat up, it change into gaseous form. It's change into gaseous form. When whole substance change into gas, we off the burner and that gas deposit on the walls of funnel. It means gas deposit on the walls of the funnel. It means gas directly change into solid. That process is known as a deposition. It's the interconversion of states of matter. Means different states of matter change into each other. After that, this chapter's last topic is Brownian movement. Last topic is Brownian movement. As साइंटिस्ट रॉबर्ट ब्राउन गिव अ एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑन दिस ब्राउनियन मूवमेंट. ब्राउनियन मूवमेंट मीन्स स्मॉलेस्ट पार्टिकल्स ऑफ द मैटर. स्मॉलेस्ट पार्टिकल्स ऑफ द मैटर शो ए जिगजग मूवमेंट. शो ए जिगजग मूवमेंट व्हेन दे आर इन ए फ्लूइड. दे आर इन ए फ्लूइड. फ्लूइड मीन्स लिक्विड और गैस. रॉबर्ट ब्राउन टेक द पोलन ग्रेन्स ऑफ फ्लावर्स एंड पुट देम इन पोर देम इन टू ए water and they show a zigzag movement. That zigzag movement is known as a Brownian movement. That movement is known as a Brownian movement. After that we have to see the daily life example, like the fragrance of perfume. When you open the bottle of perfume and spray them, the perfume's fragrance is spread all over the environment or our room, our house, etc. Why? Because of the Brownian movement. Because the particles of the perfume are very small and they are in a fluid. Fluid means in a gas. They spread all over and fragrance of perfume is spread all over. Second one, in our kitchen when we cook food, the fragrance of cooked food is spread in our house. Why? Because of the Brownian movement. Because in our house there is gaseous medium present. Okay, our chapter first is completed. That's all for today and thank you. Have a nice day.